Welcome to Unfiltered from Home. I'm Essie Cupp. Well, it's official. We have a new president. Joe Biden is the next president of the United States, but you might not know it if you watch Fox News between the hours of 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. when the network's opinion hosts are doing their damnedest to help President Trump contest the results. From Tucker Carlson to Sean Hannity, Laura Ingraham to Mark Levin, the network's most popular personalities, all of whom have substantial platforms, are using them to sow the seeds of distrust in the American electorate without any evidence to back up their paranoia. Fox was the last of the major networks to call the election for Biden, but call it they did. And this has all led to some strange schizophrenia at the network in the ensuing days, with the news division accepting their own results and the opinion side still insisting that Biden's win was in some way, anyway, illegitimate. An internal memo reveals Fox initially didn't even want its anchors and staffers to refer to Biden as the president-elect until all the legal challenges are resolved. That guidance was either changed or ignored, as several Fox anchors have indeed called Biden the president-elect, while news anchor Martha McCallum was saying the path is now clear for the new president-elect. Other Fox hosts and guests were using words like stolen, hoax, and fraud to describe Biden's win. While Trump was live-tweeting the supportive coverage of him by Fox opinion hosts and guests, he was complaining about the news division's decision to call Arizona early for Biden, as well as the Fox polls and Rupert Murdoch's seeming disloyalty. So what's a Fox viewer to believe? Fox has long attempted to split the baby, putting up an imaginary wall between news and opinion. In their defense, every network tries to set up an environment where both news and opinion can coexist together. But at Fox, the defensiveness of that imaginary wall has been noticeable and at times strains credulity. News hosts like Brett Baer, Chris Wallace, Neil Cavuto have defended their straight coverage even as Trump has criticized them for it. Fox would point to those news stars, as well as former Fox host Shepard Smith, as proof that the network wasn't just a Trump propaganda outfit. It's fitting to note that Smith left the network suddenly in 2019 over differences with the network's coverage, but pointing to the strength of the news division as an argument that it balances out the opinion side, that was always a little fraught. Now that is coming into stark relief, especially now that the opinion side is directly contradicting what the news side is saying. That seems untenable, to say the least. The point of the news side is to be treated as fact, news you can believe. But at Fox, the news side is saying, Biden won, believe us, while the same network's opinion side is saying, no, he didn't. We are who you should believe. Viewers are reacting to the disconnect. Fox enjoyed record high viewership on its primetime coverage of election night, in which the early returns were favorable to Trump. But by Saturday, when the networks were calling the election for Biden, Fox viewership plummeted. And it's getting weird between the anchors. Tucker Carlson on his program appeared to take a thinly veiled swipe at Neil Cavuto for cutting away from a Trump speech, while Fox News anchor Sandra Smith was caught incredulously reacting to a guest who questioned the election's legitimacy. Now, opinion and news don't always have to get along inside cable networks or newspapers, but when they are directly contradicting each other on something as consequential as the results of a presidential election, with each side insisting that they have it right, that reveals a bigger problem. The idea that the news side at Fox could be insulated from the opinion side when the opinion side was devoted solely to pushing the president's propaganda and often attacked the very facts the news side was presenting, well, that was always going to be problematic. And it appears to have finally come to a head. So where does the network go from here? Do its viewers side with news and accept the election results? Or do they rage with the opinion side and fight the results until Trump is marched out of the White House? Stay tuned. Okay, that's it for me. See you next week.